He said, "No, which house is it?" I said, "You can't miss it, it's the one on fire. I'll keep it going till you get here." We try our best to help people through life, don't we? Come here. A woman came up to me today. She said, "Can you see me across the road?" I said, "Hang on, I'll run over and have a look." And I bumped into this fella. He was carrying one of them big grandfather clocks. He said, "Why don't you look where you're going?" I said, "Why don't you wear a wristwatch like everybody else?" You see, we don't get the service, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, I've had a haircut. He said, "Do you want your haircut around the back?" I said, "Is there no room in the shop?" He said, "You know what needs cutting badly?" I said, "I don't want to cut badly, I want to cut properly." And he couldn't shave. He cut me there, and twice there. He said, "Do you want your head wrapped in a towel?" I said, "No, I'll just carry it home as it is." We don't get the service, do we, ladies and gentlemen? I ran into a shop. I said, "Two bottles of milk." He said, "We have none." I went back the next day. It was the day after the day I'd already been. I said, "Two bottles of milk." He said, "Look you, we don't sell milk. If you come in here again, I'm going to nail your foot to the floor." I went back the next day. I said, "Have you got any nails?" He said, "No." I said, "But two bottles of milk." "And what about the chemist last Tuesday?" I said, "Chemist last Tuesday, come here. I said, have you got anything for hiccups?" He smacked me right in the nose. I said, "What did you do that for?" He said, "You don't have any hiccups now." I said, "No, but my uncle out in the car still there." "And what about the fish and chip shop in Eastbourne?" I ran in, I said, "A bag of chips." He said, "120 or 140. I said, "We're going to count them, I'll have a fish." I went back the next night, it was the exact same fella behind the counter. I said, "Exact same fella behind the counter, come here. A bag of chips." He said, "Look you, don't you see, we're closing, we've no chips left, now get out of here." I said, "It says chips outside. I'm not leaving this shop until I get them." He said, "If you take the H away from fish, what have you got?" I said, "Fist." "I'll try not to let you go." He said, "If you take the D away from Anne, what have you got?" I said, "Anne." He said, "If you take the flip away from chips, what have you got?" I said, "There is no flipping chips." He said, "That's what I'm trying to tell you." Now, we've got a wee song released, actually, a single. It's playing a couple of the local BBC radio stations. And I did it, I gave it a bit of a rattle there. Legion, would you like to help me on with this? Every time I point, you just shout, "Ouch." Ready? Let's go practice. After three. And Mammy, that lovely, lovely, gorgeous baby as well. Oh, we look lovely. Look at that. Have you seen that gorgeous baby? Ready, everybody? Get ready. One, two, three. I want to do it twice. Ready? All right, here we go.
And it wasn't just a bad. When I was bit by Louis Suarez, I got it in then.
I was standing at a bar in Uruguay, getting ready to order a beer. When this chap rushes in and without a word of a lie, the customers all give him a cheer. He orders a large tequila, saying he has a very big thirst. I said, "I beg your pardon, excuse me, do you mind? I happen to be here first." Get ready, man.
I was in my Louis Suarez.
But he just waved my protests away. He said, "That man is a busy superstar, and besides, he hasn't eaten all day." Then he eyeballed me from head to toe, saying, "Okay, gringo, what's your beef? Mr. Swatties is a very important person. Every day, he brushes his teeth." Here we go.
I was in my Louis Suarez.
I was hopelessly outnumbered, and not knowing what to do, I took an almighty deep breath, and I headed right into the blue. I turned up at the hospital out of breath. At my wound, the doctor had a peek. He said, oh no, not you as well. You're the third one he's bitten this week. I was bit by Luby Soiree. And it wasn't just a pack. When I was bit by Luby Soiree, I got it in that knack. A few weeks later, I heard from his agent. Let her go. It said, Louis, sorry, but he mistook you for a fullback who once punched him in the nose. He said he was out of order in the bar. Of that fact, there is no doubt. But if he fights anybody else in the future, he's gonna have all his teeth taken out. Everybody! I was with my Louis Suarez. And this young, handsome man on the front, doesn't he look a little bit like Louis? He's got that lovely, swarthy, yeah, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, we're bringing realism into the... Do you play instruments? Are you musicians? Oh, look at that. I'll try and catch you before I go. So, you know, ladies and gentlemen, that football song reminds me of a story about this turkey that went to play for Chelsea. And he turned up at the training ground and he said, could I have a game? Gobble, gobble, gobble. Well, he was talking turkey. No, that's not the big laugh. That's just a little one along the way. No, I'm hoping for a big one at the end. Now, you know the manager, the coach of Chelsea, Jose Mourinho? Well, my Portuguese is a little bit rusty. I can say hello to a tipsy Italian. Hi, tiddly, hi, tie. And I did know a Spanish fireman who had two sons, Jose and Jose, right? He said to the turkey, what position do you do? And the turkey said, well, I can play both wings, right? Well, he lets him play, and this turkey is sensational. Go, go, gobble, gobble, gobble. Throw in header back here, go, go, go. Penalty kick, free kick, corner kick, scissor kick, corner kick. Offside, offside, inside, outside, front side, outside. And he scores 25 goals. No, more, 24. Jose Mourinho said, I'm going to sign you up. I'll pay you £100,000 a week. The turkey said, never mind about that. I want to ask you one thing. Am I in the team on Boxing Day? All right, we'll do a little finish now, because there's lots of people want on and nice people. Here we go, everybody. Last song before we go. Hey! I'm going home to the place where I was born. I haven't been there since I left it, that long ago, far away born. I'm going to see the mammy, fondly on her knee. She may be getting older, but it's an angel that I'll see. My friends and family will meet me at the station. There'll never be a moment quite as sweet. And when I've said hello to each relation, we'll do a little jig down in the street. I'm going home to the place where I was born, and I'm counting every hour until the next morning. Hey! Where I was born, and I'm parting every hour until the special morn. No more will I sit here all forlorn. I'm going home to the place where I was born. I'm going home to the place where I was born. Hey! Woo! Good to be here at Crawley, everybody!
Jimmy Cricket! Come on, the American! TV star! Jimmy Cricket! Absolutely right! Jimmy Cricket. Well done. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jimmy Cricket. Come on then, Jimmy. Jimmy. and he's going straight to the youngest girl in the house. Look, it's Mabel Pride.